Leveling a 3D printer has never been so easy, and you can still choose one of the three ways I'm going to show you today. Hi everyone, how are you? My name is Julia. In this video, we will talk about 3D printer build plate leveling. This is an initial and crucial step that we must do before we start printing anything. The first layer is the most important in 3D printing, and any problem with the alignment of the build plate can end up causing problems in the rest of the print. Some brands already deliver the machine leveled and ready to print, but if the prints are not adhering perfectly to the build plate, it is possible that the problem is related to the leveling. When we talk about leveling, we do not mean that the printer itself has to be leveled with the ground using a bubble level. Although, this does not affect the printing, we can level the printer with a bubble level, thus ensuring that the resin we put in the vat isn't inclined. Some printers even have adjustable fit to ensure this type of alignment. We are talking about leveling the printer's build plate in relation to the LCD, and this step can be done in different ways. In this video, we are going to show you three ways to carry out this process. But if after having done those steps you are still having problems with the adhesion of the piece to the platform, the solution may be in the exposure settings of the base layers. In this case, you can go to the video where we talked about UV exposure. We left the link in the description for you. There are some differences between each printer to adjust the build plate in place. But basically, we have screws that allow an adjustment of the position of the print platform. This leveling step is very similar for all printers, but we will also show you how to check this alignment of the platform in relation to the LCD screen. To start leveling, we must always loosen these screws without removing them completely. Here at LUT, we use standard desktop resin printers, for which, normally, the manufacturer provides a paper to perform this process. Basically, it has the same thickness as the original FAP film, 0.15 mm, and serves as a spacer. This thickness must be taken into account, as if you use a thinner or thicker paper than your FAP, it is possible that you will not come out perfect. Most suppliers will show you how to do this first leveling method. Placing the paper on top of the LCD, loosening the build plate screws, moving the printer to the home point where it descends to the end stop sensor. When holding the build plate firmly against the LCD, maintaining a homogeneous pressure, the screws must be tightened, alternating between one side and the other, and gradually tightening until it's well fixed. After this stage of tightening the screws, the Z equals 0 must be set, which tells the machine the starting position of the printing. On some machines, it's recommended to go up 0.01 mm or more after tightening the screws. We do that to guarantee the space of the first layer and only then set the Z equals 0. On other printers, it's no longer necessary, and due to these differences, we must always check the process indicated with the supplier, since new manufacturers and printer models appear all the time. The second option that can be done is a method that has the name of FLINT. Basically, instead of using paper between the LCD and the platform, we use VAT, and the FAP would have a similar function to paper. This way, it is possible to apply the same leveling process as before, regardless if your build plate is still dirty or your vat still has remains of liquid resin. This method makes the process easier if you are not sure of the paper thickness or the FAP if you change it. A small variation may not seem like much, however, it can end up causing failures in the adhesion of the first layer. It is possible to level with these last two methods, but it's harder to check if the four corners have the correct pressure, and you would probably only know after printing some objects as a test. The solution is very simple. You just divide the paper into four parts and place one in each corner. This way, we can individually check each end of the build plate and test the friction between the platform and the paper. The biggest problem when leveling is when we are tightening the screws. At this stage, we must maintain an equal pressure on the entire surface of the platform, which is not so easy since you have to maintain consistency by holding it with one hand and turning four screws with the other. When dividing the paper into four parts, we can keep the pressure homogeneous throughout the platform. After tightening the screws, we can ensure that the four corners have similar pressure, without any tighter or looser corners. This allows for manual checking without having to print test pieces in corners to check for flatness. The process remains the same. Loosen the screws, place the papers, press home for the platform to come down, equally press the platform against the LCD, and tighten the screws progressively and alternately. At this point, before tightening each screw completely, we must check if the friction on the paper is similar between each corner, thus being able to press more or less on one side to ensure good leveling. After performing these leveling steps, we must do a print test. It can be a very simple and thin piece like the one we used in the first video of this 3D printing series, so that we will check if each piece was printed correctly, especially if they are glued properly and consistently. To start printing, we must find the ideal exposure time for the resin you are using. We have already shown how to do this crucial step in one of our videos. The link is in the description. If you've done everything and your build plate isn't sticking at some point, some parts always go wrong, or even the center, the problem may not be the leveling process, but the build plate itself. There are many reports that these platforms, normally made of metal, do not come completely flat from the factory, and therefore, it would never be possible to adjust the four corners and the center equally. To solve this, there are a few ways. The most complicated would be to take it to a mechanic turner who has specific tools to adjust and remove the warp edge from the surface. Another way, which can be done at home, is to sand the build plate. There is the ideal technique to perform this step, and we shouldn't be afraid to sand a platform, because a more grooved surface helps the resin adhere. Even some newer anycubic printers already have this rough checkered pattern. Always, always ensure that the surface you are going to sand paper on is flat, like a mirror or glass. Initially, use a grain 80 or smaller sandpaper to remove more material. Make circular movements to both sides or even a figure 8 movement. Using water to sand, we can go little by little until realizing that the entire surface is sanded and even. It's as simple as it sounds. However, it's a crucial step for the success of any printing. If the process is done correctly from the beginning, it's possible to do it only once, and if you're lucky, never again. It's obvious that the build plate can be misaligned someday, but this should only happen if, when removing the pieces from the platform, you end up forcing the adjustment of the screws a lot. Since we're talking about thousands of a millimeter, little things can end up making a lot of difference. If you followed our latest videos, you already know a lot about the basics of resin 3D printing, so we would like you to share your most advanced questions. You have no idea what's coming up next. To ease your anxiety, here's a small preview of the upcoming video, a topic that many of you have asked for: the process of finishing the pieces. If I were you, I would ring the bell to receive our notifications and not miss any details of our next content. Bye!